I'm gonna say one thing.
Tune in to the POE Bullshit Podcast.
You hear me?
What's good, everybody? It's your boy Trendsettah-Press. Welcome to That Bullshit Podcast, where anything can be and or will be bullshit in my book. That's sports, entertainment, movies, albums, artists, anything is able to go down on this podcast. But today I just want to let y'all know a little bit about me. Let me talk that talk real quick for y'all, man. I'm a guy that definitely started something that has been done before, but has never been done my way. Meaning, this podcast, a lot of things goes down, or I should say a lot of people that already have a name are able to enter this world. I've been told time and time again to pretty much that I should have been done this. But me, growing up, it was just more like, you know, damn all that. I keep my opinions to myself. But at the same time, a lot of people was just like, damn, P-Nah, you might have a talent because you're a hater. And when people say I'm a hater, I just laugh it off because it's true. Certain things that I like that a lot of people don't like. But at the same time, you got to respect the things that I say and the way I say them. Because one thing I do, even though this podcast is called On That Bullshit, it's okay for you to say it, but it's never bullshit. I always bring some type of facts or points to get my point across. You understand?
The MVP was Kevin Durant. Last so, and he's still in this year. Nobody else won
the MVP. Right.
Exactly. So once again,
and LeBron should have got last year.
How when he lost? No MVP has ever went to the loser of the squad.
Bro, nobody who's ever been a fucking.
My man,
you gonna listen to me? You're not gonna listen to me.
That's what I do.
Nobody who's ever fucking started for a team and been the star of a team ever got traded, or not traded, but went to another team with a bunch of stars. He's the fourth star on one team. Get the fuck out of here, dog.
Time out. That was a team that was drafted. Was it or was it not?
I'm not drafted.
What do you mean? Who wasn't drafted?
What's your point?
But they still, Steph Curry, drafted, Klay Thompson, drafted, Draymond Green, drafted. So you gonna call them three all-stars? They worked themselves up to that. I wonder what he gonna say about my Celtics. Because them niggas, you don't even believe that. And he a Duke fan.
I'm a Carolina fan. Tune in on That Bullshit Podcast. This is Destiny Lifestyle. Follow us on Instagram, Destiny Lifestyle.
You hear me? Trendsettah-Press, we out this bitch. You hear me?
I'm a type of dude that pretty much is loyalty over money. I do this for fun, but the money will come. If people think I'm really that good, they have no choice but to listen. All my idols have big mouths. I have a big mouth, but that's just the people I looked up to. The Tupacs, the Bernie Macs, the Samuel Jacksons. The thing about Bernie Mac that everybody failed to realize is, or just from my eyes, is I never found him funny. I just felt that he was a realist. So with him being real, it was like, damn, it's okay to be real and speak your truth. When I first started this, a lot of people was telling me that I was cussing a lot. And that's the only motivation I had in my mind. And my mindset was, I don't care. Don't listen to it. I'm going to do what the fuck I want to do. I'm going to say what the fuck I want to say. I have a sailor's mouth, but at the same time, I'm very respectful. Bernie Mac said one time that when it comes down to being Bernie, and there's a time to be Bernie Mac. He said, I know how to treat myself. Me, as Trendsettah-Press, I put on that show. I give you what you want to hear. I speak my mind and keep it strong as possible. Now, when it comes down to Preston, Press, I'm cool, calm, and collected. I'm just out there. But I'm still a loudmouth. You know what I'm saying?
All right, my nigga, that's all you had to say. My nigga, you ain't had to be all...
Man, get your goddamn...
I'm your brother, bro. You supposed to be like, hey, bro. Hey.
Did I not do that shit? Hey, time out. Y'all remember when y'all niggas was arguing in the back seat about fucking clicking the goddamn seatbelt? But I just feel like however people look at me, you have no choice but to feel what I say. This podcast is just on a different level. We hold everything. We don't bite our tongues up here. That's the best way to say it. I have guests come on. I let them speak their truths. I let them speak what they got going on. This right here is my platform. And with my platform, I feel it opens up doors for the ones that are behind the doors. You know what I'm saying? Knocking to get in. If I can use my voice to shine light on my people, then that's what I'm going to do.
And I like your podcast, dude. Because I'm a talkative person. I want to do my own podcast, too. But I can't find anyone to interview.
Much with this podcast, man, I don't really know what to expect, but I'm doing something good because I got people in Canada, Jamaica, Indonesia actually listening to me. I've never been to those places, and I only been doing this for a few months. I feel my voice is so strong that in about 2 to 3 years, y'all gonna know who I am. I'm gonna have my own show, I'm gonna have my own network. That's my inner vision. You feel me? Like, my bad, bro. But I'm not there, I know. But that's what I'm saying, man. I do things to do it, and I don't expect a lot from it. But trust and believe, I'm gonna give it my all. No matter what, I'm never gonna lack, man. I'm never gonna lack, never gonna stop. I'm here for my people. And for the ones that pretty much don't really rock with what I say, it's cool, I appreciate it. But fuck your opinion, that's how I feel about it. And the ones that do rock with me, keep tuning in, man. That's on that bullshit podcast, man, with your boy Trendsettah-Press.